In March last year, the government put in place the Insurance Appeals Tribunal with the core aim of reducing case backlogs in the insurance sector. High Court judges have today embarked on a three-day capacity building workshop of the tribunal members to enhance their potential to handle disputes. While officiating at the opening ceremony of this training, which is taking place in Namanve in Mukono District, the High Court judge Musa Sekana told the tribunal members not to be shy about carrying out their duties. This follows complaints that some suspects refuse to appear in court when summoned.
If you're trying to get justice, you can cause the summons and cause an arrest. Cause an arrest. Because you're trying to defeat justice. This is your document. We expect you to come and explain or give it light. You are refusing and you say, oh, I'm not bound. Maybe the letters you are using to summon, don't make them appear like letters. Let it be summons.
Justice Sekana wants all insurance cases to be handled by this tribunal instead of forwarding them before the High Court.
People end up beginning condemning. Now they would join the bidder and PPDA. Now, deep pocket theory, the bidder has no money. So they were going for PPDA. We joined you, you lost, pay the costs. Like, no, but we're doing our work. So that's why you're likely going to find that challenge.
Establishment of this tribunal also relieved the courts, it relieves the courts of law of the burden of having to hear and adjudicate on disputes which could be resolved through administrative channels. And as the chairperson says that after the capacity building, we believe that you'll be able to do a good job.
The Insurance Appeals Tribunal has so far handled six cases worth 1.6 billion shillings. Three of these cases have already been disposed of.
The Appeals Tribunal really was set up to provide a redress mechanism in the industry to help resolve insurance complaints.
Between 2016 to 2020, the Insurance Regulatory Authority recorded a number of complaints, many of which were related to delayed settlement, life insurance, fraud, comprehensive motor insurance, and insurance policies, among others. Report by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.